all in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I thank God for this day. It is the day that the Lord has made. And we are here to worship Him. We are here to magnify Him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today we are going to hear from the Word of God. Before we open our scripture, the Word of God from the book of 2 Peter, chapter 1, it says, verse 3, His divine power has given us everything we need to live the godly life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are here today. We are given the right or the power to live the godly life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So this afternoon, we are going to share from the Word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when I read in the Bible, I've learned something about the apostle of Jesus, or rather the pillars of the church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The pillar of the church.
Peter,
John, and Apostle Paul. When I read in the scripture, I've learned most of the churches, they are founded on top of this ministry or these teachings, the teachings of Peter, the teaching of Paul, and the teaching of John. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then if church lack one of these three, it will not function well. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So let me just explain what I'm saying.
Peter
is an evangelist. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is the first after the death of Jesus Christ, he is the first one to stand. And he told the people, the Jewish, hallelujah.
Amen.
About Jesus Christ.
Abaruta ka Jesu Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then the second one, Paul.
Ilaba Paul.
After he was converted,
Maragor asukuloge.
He started teaching the church of God.
Ula thoma go ruta kereke ya Modimo.
The doctrine, how to live as a Christian.
Thuto ya rona tsone tsho phile jwang ka ge o le
mo Christian. How to conduct yourself as a Christian.
Le gore o tsone tsho itshware jwang ka ge o le mo Christian.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then the last one.
Wa mafelelo.
John is John.
Ke John.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
John is one of the apostles of Jesus Christ.
John is
one of the disciples of Jesus Christ.
He is
one of the beloved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most of the time, when the disciple missed something from Jesus, they were asking John, they say, ask him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then now John,
John,
if you can read the book of John's,
John,
or the epistle of John,
John,
most of the time, he do not see the sinners. Is he the beloved of God? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most of the time when he addressed the people, he said the beloved of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most of the time, he speaks the heart of God to the people. He do not see the sinner. He do not see the people that are doing wrongs. He see the people that are loved by God. For the word of God says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish but have eternal life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you look at Jesus, John says, behold the Lamb of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we are going to get our scripture written this afternoon from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 10.
1 Corinthians chapter 10.
We will read from verse 1 up to verse number 5.
From verse 1 to 5. 1 Corinthians chapter 10.
And jump and read verse 11.
Verse 1 to 5 and 11. For I do not want you to be ignorant of the fact, brothers and sisters, that our ancestors were all under the cloud, and that they passed through the sea. Verse 2. They were all baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea. Verse 3. They all ate the same spiritual food. Verse 4. And drank the same spiritual drink. For they drank from the spiritual rock that accompanied them. And that rock was Christ. Verse 5. Nevertheless, God was not pleased with most of them. Their bodies were scattered in the wilderness.
Verse 6.
Now these things occurred as an example to keep us from setting our hearts on evil things as they did.
Verse 11.
These things happened to them as examples and were written down as warnings for us, on whom the culmination of the ages has come.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The topic of today is, they drank from the river and died in the wilderness. They drank from the river and died in the wilderness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before I start, just read Exodus 17, verse 6.
Exodus chapter 17, verse 6. I will stand thee before you by the rock at Horeb. Strike the rock, and water will come out of it for the people to drink. So Moses did this in the sight of the elders of Israel.
Hallelujah. Where we have read,
Apostle Paul,
he was addressing the church of Corinth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, our fathers, our ancestors, hallelujah.
Amen.
They were, when from Egypt, Moses led them from Egypt, and he was taking them to the promised land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then when he, along the way from Egypt, the Israelites, they had to pass through the Red Sea. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And as they were going on their journey, the word of God says, there was a cloud that were following them.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then where we've read, he said we must not forget. The Corinthians must not forget that their ancestors or their forefathers, they were baptized in the clouds. They were baptized in the sea. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were all baptized as they left Egypt. They passed through the Red Sea. Then after they passed through the Red Sea, or when they approached the Red Sea, when they stayed on the verge of the waters of the Red Sea, the water stopped from flowing. Then they crossed on the dry land. Apostle Paul says, he said they were baptized in the water, all of them, when they passed the Red Sea. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
After they've crossed the Red Sea, they arrive at the desert. On the desert, there was nothing for them to eat. There was nothing for them to drink. Then they cried to Moses. Then Moses prayed unto God. Then God says, take your staff and go to the rock and strike the rock. And the water will come out of the rock. The water will gush out of the rock. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Paul says, they ate the spiritual food. They drink the spiritual drink. But God was not pleased with them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What made God not to be pleased with them? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He liberated them from Egypt. He was taking them to the promised land. But along the way, they were complaining. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As they continue on their journey, their mind, their heart were in Egypt. But they were going to the promised land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Paul says, this is written to us, or for us, as a warning that we must not repeat the same mistake that the Israelites did. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were free from slavery. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you read the book of Exodus, after the Egyptian, the water flowed all on top of the Egyptian. After the water covers all the Egyptians, then the Israelites were on the other side. They started to praise God. They started to worship God. But immediately, they forget. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They tell Moses, we used to enjoy. We used to enjoy meat. We used to enjoy the watermelon in Egypt. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Here we are at the wilderness. There is no food. Here we are at the wilderness. There is no water. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, the word of God where we've read, it said they were all drink from the same river. Hallelujah.
Amen.
From the same river. From the same river. They received their blessing from the same river. There's something important about the river. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The river, it has the power to liberate. It has the power to refresh. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the river there is water. And the water refreshed. The water revived. Hallelujah. The water gives life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the children of Israel, they were blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When they go out of Egypt,
there
were under the direction or under the guidance of God. God was directing them. God was telling them what to do. Where to stop. Where to turn. What to do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And all of them, this Israelites, there was a cloud that was making a shadow for them. There was a cloud. There was a pillar. The pillar of fire. When it is dark, it will give them light. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When it is hot,
this
cloud will cover, will protect them. This Israelites, they were protected under the clouds. All of them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says all of them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
All of them were protected. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then when they arrive in the desert, when there's no food for them, God provided for them. He rained the manna for them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Paul says they ate the spiritual food in the desert. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They ate the food that they did not prepare. It was prepared by God for them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah. And all of them, they crossed the Red Sea as a sign that they are delivered from bondage. In Egypt, they were slaves. Immediately after the Red Sea, they are free. They are no longer slaves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Paul says,
Paul,
they are delivered across the Red Sea, all of them, and they were all delivered at the Red Sea.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There's something that Paul says, God was not pleased with them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He delivered them. He provided for them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He protected them. But he was not pleased with them. May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, after they crossed the Red Sea, on the desert, they started to complain. They started to complain. They say it was better in Egypt. It was better when we were still slaves. At least there was food for us there. At least there was water for us there. The Christian nowadays, Jesus came and died for them. And he liberated them from the chain of the devil. But the Christian are complaining every day. They say it was better when we are still the sinners. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People are complaining. They complain in the churches. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They say it was better in Egypt. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are free, my sister. You are free, my brother. Continue on your journey. On Sunday, we were taught. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That sometimes along the way, there will be some hurricanes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There will be some storms. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then when there is a storm, do not go back. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yesterday,
Mabani,
when I was coming into the church, the servant of God was said something. The conversation between Jesus Christ and the Samaritan woman. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I didn't hear the message. I was not here. I arrived late. I only heard him saying, Jesus told the Samaritan woman, woman, there comes a time where the true worshippers will not worship me on this mountain. They will not worship me in
Jerusalem.
They will worship me in truth and in spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, children of God, we are on the journey and we have crossed the Red Sea and we are on the other side of the Red Sea and we are approaching the promised land. Paul warns us. He said we must not be like the Israelites. We must not murmur or complain like the Israelites. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even though they were delivered, even though they were provided, even though they were protected, but still they complained.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you. The river.
Nuka.
He said they all drink from the same river. This river is the source of life. This river is the source of life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's a sign that they must rely or depend on God for their direction and for their provision. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then the other thing that I want to tell you, drinking from the river, drinking from the river does not guarantee you, does not guarantee you a future success. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Drinking from the river does not guarantee me, does not guarantee you the future success. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We as Christians, we enjoy the anointing of God, but we do not enjoy the character, the godly character. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We enjoy what we see. We enjoy what the people will see. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But the character of God, let me just explain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to give the example by the worshippers. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most of us, we want to come and stand here on the stage and worship God, but we do not want to sit down and worship God. What is the reason? Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we are standing here, everybody, they will see us and they will know that we are anointed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we stand here, they will speak about us. How best these people can sing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But when I'm serving God, behind the scene, I tend to be discouraged. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just because people do not see me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The children of God, they want exposure. They do not want God's character. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The godly character does not come overnight. I cannot lay hand on you to receive the godly character. I can lay hand on you when you are sick and you are healed. I can lay hand on you and you receive the anointing of God. I can lay hand on you and you start to speak in tongues. But the godly character, you develop them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The church of God nowadays, there's a problem in the church of God. We lack the godly character. We want the anointing of God. We want the blessing of God. But we do not want godly character. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Church of God is the reason why I say the river or drinking from the river does not guarantee you the future success. Anointing today does not guarantee you, if you live the reckless life, that you will arrive at the promised land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Israelites,
Israelite,
all of them, they left Egypt.
And
they started to celebrate immediately after the Red Sea. Only two of them arrived. The rest died in the wilderness. What was the problem? Their behavior. Their character. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were going to Canaan, but complaining. They were going to Canaan, hating one another.
Bashoyani.
They were going to Canaan.
Halebaya kanana.
And they were gossiping.
Ba seba.
Barna mudimi obulela ka Moshe felana.
But does God only talk to Moshe? Moses.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Na mudimi obulela ka Moso felana.
Ana, does God only talk to Moses alone?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is the reason why they did not arrive in the promised land. Only two of them arrived. The Bible says, when it speaks about Caleb, the Bible says he had different spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He did not follow the rest of the people. He followed God wholeheartedly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When they went to spy the land, the other people saw the giant. When they look at themselves, they say, no, we are just the grasshoppers. But Caleb, he said, we can possess that land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The rest of the people, they say, no, let's go back to Egypt. They will kill us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Israelites.
By Israelites.
They never pass from the place of their privilege. They never pass from the place of privilege. The privilege as the people of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Unto the purpose of God. To be called the priest of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were just the people of God. Not the priest of God. What made them not to be the priest of God? Their character. Their behavior. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were walking with the people of God. Working with the priest of God, but they were people of God. Churches are full nowadays by the people of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We do not have the priest of God. We do not have people that follow God wholeheartedly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are in the church. We want to see what is going to happen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the churches, we need blessings. But we cannot carry the burdens that comes with the blessings of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We seek the presence of God, but we do not search our purpose in God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We need the presence of God. You ask somebody when it's after the service, he will say, I was blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But we do not want to know why God was saying this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why God was telling us this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God, when he speaks to Moses, he said, Moses, you did not represent me well before the people. Let us read the book of Numbers. Numbers chapter 20. Then we'll... Just read verse 12 only.
Numbers chapter 20, verse 12. But the Lord said to Moses and Aaron, because you did not trust in me enough to honor me as holy in the sight of the Israelites, you will not bring this community into the land I give them.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You misrepresented me before these people. You did not honor me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Moses, the servant of God, he'll take the message from God and give to the
Israelites.
When they complain,
you
go back to God and report to God. God give him the direction. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But in this case, the Israelites angered Moses. Hallelujah. By keep on complaining. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then God told Moses, go and speak to the rock. Then the rock will gush out the water for the Israelites to drink. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because of anger, he strike the rock. The water comes out. The Israelites drink. But he did not arrive. He did not arrive to the promised land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The word of God says, or God said to Moses and Aaron, you did not treat me as holy before the people.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You did not treat me as holy before the people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We live in a time where churches, we speak of the Spirit. We enjoy talking in tongues, but we do not want the character.
Of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is the reason why you find the minister of God. He stand before the people, then minister, but at the end, or after ministering, his life does not go in line with what he was saying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are content to pursue the experience. We want to experience God. We want to experience God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to experience the presence of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to experience the healing of God. We want to experience the deliverance of God. We want to experience the protection of God. But we do not want the God who protects. We want the blessings, but not the God of that bless. To prove that we do not want God that blesses us, someone go to church sick. Then they pray for him. Then he stand up. Then we'll attend 2-3 days. After 3 days, when he's well, he goes back to his things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We come to church not working. They pray for us. Then we receive our job. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We do not have time to attend church any longer. We do not have time to attend service any longer. We want the blessings of God. We want to experience the blessings of God. But God himself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want the deliverance of God. But we do not want God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So as I'm closing, Paul says, can you read 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 11 only?
First Corinthians chapter 10, verse 11. These things happened to them as examples and were written down as warnings for us, on whom the culmination of ages has come.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This thing, the things that happened to the Israelites, it is an example to us that we must not follow on their footsteps. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were delivered. They were protected. They were provided. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But they did not arrive to the promised land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most of the time, we are crying for the anointing, but we cannot handle We cannot handle the pressure that comes with the anointing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Most of the time, we cry for blessings. When the blessings come, we cannot handle it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
See, you go outside the churches, you'll find somebody who was born again. Who was born again? But he was a minister. Or an evangelist. But he couldn't handle the anointing. He end up backsliding. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. As I'm closing, I'm reminded of a servant of God. He held a conference. Then he preached. A lot of people were born again or received Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When he left that place, the people were blessed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was the last time. It was the last time. It was the last time he stand before the people and preach. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The reason is he couldn't control himself after preaching. The woman came to him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He couldn't control himself. He ended up backsliding. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There was nothing wrong with the message that he preached. But he lacked self-control. The Israelites, they lacked self-control. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were delivered, but they couldn't control themselves. May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I said,
Kirile,
the godly character, you need to build it. You need to develop it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
How can you build the godly character?
I've said
the servant of God yesterday, when I entered the door, I didn't hear the whole message. I only heard when he said, the Samaritan woman and Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We can develop. We can develop the godly character by fellowshipping with Jesus Christ. By having intimacy with Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And by living the holy life, the key to the godly character is the intimacy with God and living the holy life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is the key. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's the reason why John chapter 15
verse 7
If you abide in me, abide in him, abide in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If we if you dwell in him every day, your character will change. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The problem with the children of God, we don't have time with God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We do not have time with God. But we want the things of God, but we don't have time with God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You ask somebody who did not attend the service, the answer will be I do not have time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When last did you pray?
I
didn't have time.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. We do not have time with God. We have got our own time to run our own business, to do our own things, but we do not have time to fellowship with God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of us, where we are working, even if they say, do not come to work tomorrow, I'll try by all means. No, I say, no, I'll come and work. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But if we can say, come, let us pray, only few people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If we can say, come, let us sing, this stage will be full. But when we go to prayer, there will be only two people or one. Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the good Lord bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Paul says, this thing was written as an example for me and you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We must not repeat the same mistake what the Israelites did. Hallelujah.
Amen.